Hello, infiltrating tubers, and welcome back. Let's play XCOM Long War 2 and 2 with me, BlueAnkylo, also episode 2. So, welcome back, folks. Last episode, we went over sort of the first basic mission, and we did a little bit of campaign stuff. Today, we're going to start with our first mission. So, we've got a jailbreak to pop, a jailbreak-type mission, that is to say, in India. There's a bunch of numbers here. Advent strength 1 means by default the Advent is not focusing on this area specifically. That's as low as it goes, I believe. I've showed you guys about the haven management, the income projection and all that. And I think maybe because of the good intel, lots of resistance members doing, you know, looking for missions, we've actually got a reasonable amount of time on this one. So let's give it a shot. Operation Tombblade. And the goal here is to rescue some rebels. Now, I found in Long War 2 1.0, I almost always just got resistance operatives. This time, though, there are rookies here. There's two rookies and one resistance personnel, which is... I'm not sure if it's... Either we got kind of lucky on this one, or they may have changed it in the update to 1.1. Because usually I found a huge rookie shortage in Long War 2 at the beginning. But maybe now they're giving you more soldiers a little bit easier. So anyway, yeah, we got like a couple random recruits, two rookies, and one just resistant personnel. So, important things. Based on your difficulty, you get different base infiltration timers, I believe. And then the amount of people... sort of affecting the squad time changes on class and perks and all that. So, we've also got squads to deal with, and I'm not going to go into them super in-depth right now, but I do have the ability to change icons and all that. So that looks pretty cool. We can change the name and all that later on. For now, I'm thinking I don't want to just send the all-squaddy group, because in the time it takes to infiltrate this mission... we'll probably have, I would expect, two or three other missions. So I kind of want to split my forces up and start bringing some more rookies so that they can get leveled up as well. Getting to your class is perhaps the best upgrade you can get, because rookies are pretty terrible. Now, on the other hand, we can't really do a full 8-man squad here. We can almost do 7, but it depends on what that soldier is. So... there might be a way to get the time down with 7 people. I'm not sure we can pull it. I think we're going to have to do a 6-man team if I want to do this easily. So, 6-man, hey? That's kind of small. Well, I don't want to bring... I guess we'll just clear it out for now. Let's, we'll say this is the squad to do it. And, we'll bring, like, let's say 2 squaddies to train up 4 rookies, I guess. I feel like the most valuable squaddy is probably the shinobi, because of the concealment thing. So if I bring him, that should make the mission a fair bit easier. And then we'll add in, I think rangers are also very, very powerful. And grenadiers, once they get, well, at level 1, they're not that powerful, but... also, what kind of mission is this? This is a jailbreak, so we do have to unlock a door. But having a specialist for a long range hack is not as important. Well, I'm not going to bring an assault. We'll go with a shinobi and a grenadier, and then we'll just bring in the next 4 rookies. No real priority here on stats. I'm just bringing the next 4, and then we'll deal with what class they get once we're done the mission. Maybe we can fit one more rookie? Oh, it's so close. Now, I probably could do this. If I was willing to change the gear, because submachine guns have a lower, they have a negative for gear modifier. And the grenadier actually is adding 3 hours, so maybe if I put just all rookies? Oh, that'll do it. Okay, well, as much as I was going to have two, well, okay, maybe a different squaddy that doesn't add the negative penalty. The technical has rocket launchers, so that probably slows them down. Gunner's pretty slow. Sure, we'll bring a ranger. So it's a pretty strong squad in terms, compared to what I thought we were going to get. That gives us, you know, stealth, double shot, and a bunch of rookies to train up. I'm not going to really play with their loadout too much right now. While I say that, I'm going to give my infantry, Mr. Moose here, I'm going to give him a med kit, just so if anyone's bleeding out. Also, he's got pretty bad mobility. I could open up an inventory slot. That would give him a little bit more mobility, but you can pick med kits, and at least that way, if someone's bleeding out, we have a way of saving them. Other than that, a bunch of rookies with grenades and stuff should be fine. So, again, I'll deal more with squad management once we've got officers and a more set squad, because right now we'll still be mixing matching as we go along just to pick the min-maxing who to go on what mission right now. So anyway, I think the timer should work out. The goal here, in case I haven't explained it or you haven't picked it up yet, the goal is to get these infiltrations to 100% or like 101%. Every 10 to 20% along the way will lower the activity, and then at 100% it should be what they originally predicted, which was extremely light with not terrible readiness. Going past 100% does help, but only at certain breakpoints, 125, 150, and 200, I believe. So unless you really want to invest a lot of time, it's not going to make a whole lot of difference. And I'd rather have more soldiers, really. Okay, so that mission's done. Biotech's getting there. Now, I was actually thinking about it in between episodes. This might not have been the right research to go for next. Biotech is good for the plot, and we will do it eventually, but I think I probably should have gone for mod weapons after contacts. Possibly this one before contacts, because we have weapon mods already, we've got a few, and this will let us equip them, so that'd be good. In convincing the remaining civilian population to migrate to their city centers, with the propaganda campaign providing a constant stream. Sorry, this guy confused. This guy totally threw me off my dialogue. What I wanted to talk about was resistance management. Tigan, shut it up! Most of these unwitting refugees have little idea what they are truly signing up for. Okay, you get it. I get it. Thank you. I like those. I wish I could turn them off during the Let's Play. If you're playing it solo, it's all good, but... So what I wanted to do was I wanted to assign a Haven advisor here. Now, I think rookies are not allowed, but I think squaddies are allowed. They just can't be in a squad. I can also send engineers and scientists at some point, although right now that's probably a bad idea. Sorry, wrong button again. If I go to squad management, Sandman squad, did I put the history in there? This was the squad that got very first mission, got the got tutorial mission. I'm really good at typing, guys. When I'm on camera, it's amazing. Look, I'm so good at typing. But we can put in little notes for squads if we end up with groups of people that, it'll show up here and you can keep track of it. It's kind of cool. Anyway, I want to, you guys! I want to send one of these people to be a Haven. Seriously. Okay.
I appreciate the sentiment.
Is there seriously no way to shut these guys off? Like, I could turn the voice volume down or something, but...
Get it done! Go!
But I mean, that'll affect everything. I don't think there's an option to do what I want, which is just the voiceover to not happen. Anyway, all I'm trying to do is pick someone that's a squaddy to not be in the squad to go manage the Haven for a little while. For various reasons. And I think I'm going to send Panda there for now. Don't worry, Panda. I'll pull you back into the mainline duty eventually. But for now, I need someone to look after this little group. And I generally find technical are some of my least valuable. Especially early on. So the way it works is soldiers as an advisor count as recruit. Or at least they boost recruiting or something like that. So it'll help us get more units. Engineers help supply, and scientists help intel. I'm not sure exactly how the mechanics work. I think the higher the rank of soldier, the better. You can see the rank shows up under Haven Advisor here. And, maybe they boost recruits, so having one doesn't do much. Perhaps. But if I can get two or three more people, I'll put them into our In fact, if we finish our mission, we'll get one more. I can put him into recruiting automatically, and then maybe two is enough to get some new people. I find, so far, intel of 5 or 6 is pretty good for getting missions you can do. And then supplies, we're not going to worry about until a secret time later. Anyway, let's continue. Wasting all this time. Alright, so that'll tick up. We could launch it at any point, but we would lose our squad, or at least lose the mission, so... Let's not do that. So we gotta finish making contact here in West Asia. Saying hello to the Russians. Alright, we got mission number 2. Another long timer, which is good. Like, having 7 days like this is great. And it gives us intel and an intel package, which has like a surprise bonus, we don't know. So Operation Dismal Hammer, let's get this one set up. Looks like, I think 7.5 days is more than enough. Maybe 7-man team if we're lucky. Again, we lose a couple hours flying over, unfortunately, but... So, let's make a new squad. Again, we're kind of keeping... For now, the Sandman was the, I will want to rename these, so, like, if you have good suggestions for squad names, just leave them in the comments there. In fact, I forgot to mention at the beginning of the video, I'm still accepting, soldier names as well for a while. So yeah, we've got those guys out, we've got this guy's ready to go. We can assign soldiers here if we want, although it doesn't make too much difference. Switch this over. So I'm thinking, again, I'm going to want one or two of the squaddies to kind of train these rookies up a little bit. So maybe we'll start with, like... Okay, what is the mission? Again, double check. So this is a hacking mission, hack the workstation. So I think having the specialist on this one makes sense, so Lady Blue can go. And I think I'll back her up. So those two, that's a good start. And then we'll throw in some rookies. Gotta bring your wife on important missions, right? So we got like... Oh, I forgot to go over all the names. I'll spend more time showing off the individual soldiers as time goes on. If you guys are interested in how you all look. We might be able to get one more, but it's gonna be pretty close. Yeah, that's a little bit too much. 8 hours. It's probably because I'm bringing myself as a gunner. Like, if I switched myself out for... That's still a lot of extra hours there. Just trying to see if there's a way to fit this all in. Maybe just Lady Blue takes a team of all rookies? Still plus 5 hours. Okay, so I'm not really adding all that much time as a gunner. Well, three, but... I think we just do this with a 6-man team. As much as it'd be nice to go on 7 or 8 mans, we don't really have enough time. I can switch out like submachine guns, and that's minus 1 hour each for an assault rifle. But they also do less damage and everything, so... Alright, well, one of the things that we'll be doing... Oops. Eventually here is... my specialists will generally be the ones with medkits. So make sure we've got those ready. I often switch them over to submachine guns as well. If they're going to go run over and heal people, and they have to be kind of speedy for hacking anyway, so I feel like maybe the mobility is worth it there. And then the gunners have big guns, you know, awesome. But yeah, who else have we got on the team besides, you know, me and the wife? We've got Fella McGubbins here backing us up with, well, we'll see what kind of gun he gets. And we got Gray Arius. Is that someone? I think that's someone from... Yeah, anyone with a nickname at Rookie is definitely someone I added in. We've got... Technico Palali. Call him Tech. And we've got... Jobot Jones. So we'll send these guys out. I better not die. Gonna be very upset. But yeah, Long War 2... One of the things that's pretty common is a lot of missions running concurrently. So I feel like having enough soldiers to send a few out at once is pretty smart. So some of the animations might be a little bit weird. I've tried to install a couple mods that's called Quit Wasting My Time, I believe. And it's supposed to shorten some animations that waste your time. Like the animation for switching between the geoscapes. It's supposed to be running a little bit faster. I'm not sure if it's even working, really. So if things look different, you know, I'm just trying to save a little bit of time, that's all. Whether or not it's even working is questionable. Yeah, I mean, it seems like that was a pretty slow animation just to land in West Asia, so I'm not sure if it's even working. Communication from the Resistance. I hope you enjoy going on missions. Oh, we got this one instantly. So, usually this is like a spoiler if you're playing for the first time, but this was really quick. Operation Drunken Law, go now. So, we're going to India right away. And by we're, I mean Panda's going to have to cover this one on his own, basically. So, if you assign a soldier as the Haven advisor, you will sometimes get these missions. I wonder what's going to happen. Well, Operation Drunken Law it is. So apparently there's a spy meeting with Advent forces. I guess the spoiler effect here is if you had units in your resistance gathering supplies, if you have a spy, and you pretty much always start with a spy, I think, you don't get very many of your supplies actually added. So in this situation, this is actually quite nice to have this pop immediately. So we've been tracked them to a meeting site. No time for Avenger support, so we have no regular soldiers except for the existing agents and one of ours, our advisor.
Entering squad concealment.
Fortunately, we start in concealment. So we've got four people here, which does not bode well because there's supposed to be six. So keep that in mind as we go forward. Remember, there was six resistance members in India. Jeez, we're not off to a great start on that sort of term. Alright, well. So, the interesting thing with these maps, from what I've learned, is they're very rectangular. We could go to the right, and we should at least get some vision there, but for the most part, we're going to be going straight forward, because there's a long, long way to go to get to the end, and there'll probably be the enemies at the other end of the map. Generally. It's not, like, guaranteed, but I've done these a few times, so I feel like I've got a pretty good feel, pretty good idea. One thing that's pretty cool about these type of missions is that as your tech tree grows and your resistance spreads, your baseline resistance fighters also get new gear that you don't have to buy. They like scavenge them themselves or find them off of dead Advent or something. So eventually, instead of just all having assault rifles, just ballistic guns, they will upgrade to lasers and stuff eventually, at least. Alright, well there's a big wall here. Feel like I don't want to spend like a super long time doing this mission. You know, it's a little bit scary, but you know, we've got things, we've got places to go, people to see. So let's do a couple gold moves to speed it up. We do have Panda Ace here, our first technical. So we've got access to a rocket launcher and a flamethrower, which perhaps we'll have good use for. The flamethrower has been modified in patch 1.1. So this will look a little different than a 1.0 version. I'm not sure if I'm a huge fan of it just yet. It seems to have less range to me, and it does less damage. And, I mean, I don't know if it's more realistic, but I haven't really enjoyed the flamethrower much. I don't really enjoy the rocket launcher all that much either, unfortunately. But we'll have to test them out some more. I was hoping for a sound ping to give a direction, but we did not get anything. Looks like there's some destroyed house over there. We should at least have a look.
On the move.
Theoretically, there could be something going on that way. That did not give us very good vision. Could easily be... Well, we didn't get a sound ping, so if there was agents... If there was a... Advent walking around there, I would be very surprised.
Let's do this.
Shang Lu, huh? Alright, but mostly we want to keep moving up this way. Well, I say that. Let's get a look over here so we don't flank ourselves accidentally, and then we'll move that way. Alright, nothing there. And then we'll just move up a little bit. We won't go past this line yet. Till next turn. And then we'll send Panda up this way to keep an eye. Remember, we're in concealment for now, so we can run into the first pod without activating it as long as I'm a little bit careful. Alright. That's what I needed to see. Now I have an idea where to go. So we've heard them. They are probably right behind that car, is my expectation. I don't want to move that far, because if they're closer, we'll accidentally activate them before I'm ready. Okay, they're probably not that close, but still, let's be smart about this.
Rolling.
Oh, also, some of them have submachine guns. Most of them get a frag grenade and a flashbang, but sometimes you'll see smoke grenades and sometimes you'll see submachine guns rather than the default loadout. Just do a blue move just in case. Alright, that's pretty good vision from Panda. Then we can move over. Pretty safe. Still have not even seen them yet, so I feel like we've got a fair bit of space to maneuver.
Double time.
But we have a fairly small team here.
Copy that.
I generally like to do these missions with more than four
Roger. I've got my eyes on
four resistance members.
I think I hear something.
Be nice to have like five or six at least. Like this is a pretty small group. I've done this with three before. Like two resistance members and one advisor. That gets pretty hectic pretty fast. Alright, well, let's move up to the tree and then the rocks. Just in case they're close. Alright, we found them. Good. So we've got two troopers and a drone. Technically, they all drop loot. In 1.0, your resistance members could not pick up loot. Only your soldier could, your actual XCOM soldier. But in 1.1, they changed it so anybody can pick up loot. So getting the loot would be nice. But we might not have that kind of option, because we're probably going to have to grenade spam them to death. Because I don't have a lot of options with such a low-level, low-gear force. This direction's fine. They're not going to... As long as we don't move too much closer, we shouldn't have anything to worry about this turn. Even if they patrol straight towards us, we'll be far enough back. Now, the optimal engagement here is clearly from the high ground in full cover. So if they do come towards me, that would be good. I would like them to come a little bit closer as well. Alright, so Panda... I mean, we might open... If I can get close enough to hit them with the flamethrower, that would be, like, a pretty great way to open the fight up. But there is more on the map than just this one pod. There's generally two pods of Advent soldiers on these type of missions. So keep that in mind. And also, submachine guns pretty bad at long range, so... They're not going to be one of my primary damage dealers here, really. So we can put them on the low ground. They'll probably be my... Well, I might have to open with a frag grenade or something, because they smoke is not going to help us a whole lot. But people with assault rifle... Well, I guess in case you haven't explained that, we get a height advantage from being above them. No range penalty with the assault rifle. Does anyone else have a submachine gun I can demonstrate with? Now, if I can get line of sight here... Sure, we'll move up to here. Just so I can explain how this works. Submachine guns get a small weapon range penalty. Kind of like a shotgun, but not as bad. So, generally speaking, less damage and less good at range. So you want to keep them... Aw, man, another smoke. The two people I would want to do a flashbang opener both have the wrong grenade type here. That's kind of annoying. But yeah, I think I'll leave the people with assault rifles up on the ridge. And then these two will try flanking or grenades or whatever we need to do. Or at least move close enough so they can actually hit. Basically, the plus 10 height advantage doesn't counteract the long range penalty. Alright, so maybe this turn... What do I want to do? I have to move over one more square because of the tree. So one thing here, the detection range is smaller if you have a submachine gun. So if we click someone else, you can see the weapon range, like, it's not safe there for someone with an assault rifle. Depending on there's also perks and stuff. Depends on their detection rating. But someone with a submachine gun can get a lot closer, which is certainly useful. Alright, hold up. How do I want to do this? This counts as full cover, which means you generally can't see through it. We do have a couple flashbangs on my shooters. I could go with a rocket. A rocket would certainly kill them all. But I kind of want to save that for an emergency, because I only have the one. The drone... is immune to flash. I think we're gonna go with guns on this one. Because the people I want to use grenades aren't really able to do that. 66% is not great. And that's... See, that's the trouble. This is a flank shot. If we use an Overwatch shot, it's actually less than this. It'll be like 40 or 50%. And once they're in cover, they're basically impossible to hit. Like, minus 45 off of 66 is... You're never going to hit anything. Now, with height... We might straight up kill one with the first shot, which would be a really good start. Do I want Overwatches? You've already moved. I could also open with a normal grenade. It might kill them. It might not kill them all. You know what? That's what we're going to do. I changed. Okay, I got my plan. We're going to go a couple Overwatches. If the grenade kills them, no big deal. If it leaves them with like 1 HP, that's kind of perfect. Because then a graze will kill them with the Overwatches. And I would really like to shred the armor on the drone so that if we do hit it, it probably dies rather than soaking up a bunch of 2 damage shots and 1 armor absorbing every shot kind of thing. So if we target on the drone, it'll probably kill the drone, or at least very close to it. I feel like this is the right choice. It actually did very little damage. It killed nothing. It's a pretty bad grenade. Hopefully we can get a couple kills. Yeah, 1. That's a 2. Everything but the drone. That's not... Or, wait. Did we... we hit the drone, but we didn't kill it. Shoot. Well, I mean, could have been worse. Could have been worse. Now, one of the perks is the enemy get red fog, so they'll have a debuff because of their wounds. But I've only got 1 person left. So that was, what, 3 shots? They did not kill the drone. We could smoke, we could do stuff like that. We're not messing around. I don't know if this car will explode, so I just want to make sure this guy dies. They've also nerfed grenade damage to cars, so cars explode less frequently now. It looks like it will explode at some point. Alright, now this guy's gonna get a free Oh! You saved it! You saved your Overwatch. See, I thought I only saw them shoot twice, so I was confused, right? Alright, well, it worked out. I maybe didn't need to use the grenade on the last guy. You know, I probably destroyed some of my loot, but on the other hand, nobody got hurt. Good. So we've used 2 grenades. These 2 are out of grenades now, but we still got the 3 flashes and all of the technical fun stuff. Good. That was a fine pod. Not going to complain about that. I was hoping we would not activate here, but we did anyway, so that's an engineer and a trooper. And that's the spy! Surprisingly difficult to hit, you gotta say. We're standing out there flanked. Well... It's gonna be... Now that they're activated, it's gonna be better if they come back to us on the high ground, so let's just pull back. I do want that loot, though. You can make it. That's good. So I'll send the other submachine gunner sort of around to the left flank after picking this up. Again, it was really annoying when only your soldier, your XCOM agent, could pick those up. We definitely want to be far enough back that they have to run into an Overwatch to get to us, basically. So we're going to keep Panda up here. And just trying to think for line of sight. So, like, Shang Liu had a hard time getting vision there. So I'm going to move him up. He's only got half cover, but a better shot. And I guess this angle seemed to be okay from behind the tree. So we'll stick with that for Amani. They did not attack. Well, we're not in any rush, so... I'm sure they activated, so I see no reason to move out right now. We'll let them come to us. Let's everyone get reloaded and everything. Come get some. We've got even more Overwatches now. Alright, let's do it! Alright, that was really lucky. 35% hit. Oh yeah, by the way. So it turns out, one of our agents, one of our resistance members was a monster. Good stuff. Maybe I didn't activate them, because that looks like their first scamper. Oh well, I'm not going to complain. I thought they activated when I picked up the loot. So these guys are real hard to take down, unfortunately. Especially when we can't get a hit on them. You can see they've got 20% dodge. So they'll be downgrading hits into grazes and grazes into misses all the time. There's a graze at least. Halfway killed him. That's about as good as I could expect from Overwatch. So, could be worse. Okay, the other thing is, these guys also regenerate. Look at their stats here. So, it doesn't show it, but they regenerate, I believe, 2 or 3 HP every turn. Kind of like some of the Long War 1 critters. So I'm thinking pull back a little bit further. They won't be in range of us. They'll have to move again. Smoke grenade is not going to help us here. So let's just pull Mihir back. These guys also only attack in melee anyway. So, give me that 67. Well, that's about as much as you could expect. Alright, what about my other submachine gun? You've got a shot. 51% is not great. I'd rather save the assault rifles for Overwatch if I can. Got him. Okay, we got a little bit on the lucky side there, so I'll take that. And then these guys can continue Overwatching for incoming advent. This is looking pretty good so far, but... And we'll see what happens here when they move up. Alright, well, it's only fair. We did not get a lot of Overwatches, unfortunately. Alright, well, they're taking pretty bad shots. He's only in half cover. Well, I gotta believe that we can hit this guy in half cover. It's actually like two-thirds cover, technically. Alright, 47%. You can do it! Oh, you gotta believe. You gotta believe. You got no ammo. So, reload, I guess. Reload. How do I want to do this? Honestly, just pulling back so they have to come at the Overwatch trap is probably smarter. Don't want my submachine gun. I don't want someone just isolated out here. Yeah, so a couple Overwatches for whoever moves up. I'm going to overkill this a little bit. I mostly want to make sure I hit the guy that's in half cover. But I can hit all four here, so that'll be helpful. Smoke is, I believe, plus 20 defense, so I think we can see that here. Maybe? Maybe not. But I'm pretty sure base level smoke is worth 20 anyway. Don't forget I've got rockets and flames. I don't want to move off my hill right now. Are you going to take this low shot here, or are you going to move? You're going to move! Oh, come on, guys. Come on! Oh, you guys suck! I got 3! 2 shots and a miss. Alright, well, a 1% is acceptable, I guess. Okay, well, we should be able to flank this guy. The downside here is this guy's got an Overwatch. So I think maybe this guy gets nuked. Yeah. Take that. I don't care if I lost the loot. We got him. Alright, this should be it. Easy to flank. This guy made a critical mistake, not expecting rockets. 73%. Right in the back. I'll take a graze. Good fight, everybody. Positive confirmation. Area secured. Alright. Mission accomplished. Well, that was a good first real mission. I find those missions aren't too difficult. They're pretty small, so, you know, it's not so bad. We had a couple lucky shots, a couple unlucky shots. Felt like the the RNG was relatively neutral overall. We managed to keep the enemy from getting any good shots at all. So if they're taking 1% and 10%, hey, you know, we got a pretty good chance, I feel. I really like being able to see the enemy's accuracy. In vanilla Long War 2 and XCOM 2, you can't see their chance to hit. So you always feel like they're cheating. But now you get to see their stats. And, you know, if they're taking 10% shots, we're doing pretty good. Like, the AI, I assume, will take the best shot they can. And if the best shot they've got is 10%. Well, we got a quick promotion for Panda there. First promotion to Lance Corporal. Congratulations. So, you know, you've got your flamethrower and your rocket launcher. Feel free to read through all of that. As far as perks go, well, oh, I forgot to turn on. There's an option in Long War that you see all the perks. I'll have to remember to turn that on later. We can kind of go down the rocket route or the fire flamethrower route or the shooting gun route. I don't know. Rocket's more accurate, maybe? I guess we don't have to choose right now, but I think with... Personally, I feel like the 1.1 patch to flamethrowers kind of nerfed them a little bit. There's a perk further down that gives you a bigger AoE with the flamethrower, but it's way down here. I think for now, rockets is probably our best choice. This just makes them more accurate, and then later on we'll get other perks to it. And no one was injured. Not bad. A couple more weapon mods. We do get to keep some of the corpses, unless we blew them up. Well, don't worry about that. Alright, so mission done. Well, that was a lot quicker than I expected. Let's check my timer here. Well, it's still been 36 minutes. Well, we won't quite end the episode here, though. We'll go until whatever the next mission is, and then I can prep for that in between episodes. But yeah, that was good. So, we're still not done making our first contact. Let's continue that. Oh, I suppose hit resistance management. I should have a look at my numbers. So, we lost one of the people gathering intel, unfortunately. I'm going to switch over. I think finding these missions is more important than getting new recruits at this exact moment. And technically, we only found one spy. There could have been more than one. So technically, we could try gathering supplies now, but there could have been more than one. And it's just going to take some time for Panda to find out if there's any other ones. But that was unusually quick. It normally takes like an entire month at least. So like that was surprising, really. I was not expecting that at all. All right, weapon mods. Good. Next team can have some weapon mods. So also, once we've got our proving ground and we've gathered up some basics, we can study them and then learn how to build them ourselves. Suppressors give you a better infiltration bonus. Autoloaders, free reload. Better overwatch aim. More ammo or clip size. A steady weapon ability, so you can add aim and crit chance to your next shot on the next turn. Laser sights is like critical bonus, but only really at close range. Basically just for assaults for the most part. Scopes are really good, plus aim for normal shots. And congratulations, you can use weapon mods. Perfect. Well, let's go back to biotech then. We're making short work of these research. That's why I bought that scientist, guys. It's great to be ahead of tech. Whoa, super loud. Sorry guys. I don't know why some of the cutscenes like ignore my volume settings. Anyway, Vigilo Confido Commander, we've got another contact. And if I had lots of intel, we could theoretically expand further, but that we do not. We will want to build a radio tower here first, and then from here expand out. Because it costs, you know, double intel. Well, you guys can see, right? Like, it's 80 intel times link distance to nearest radio relay. So, you know, we're doubling, and then it's 240, and then 320. If it's, you know, it's probably a good idea to keep building radio towers. What we could do here is assign another advisor. We probably will do that. For now, though, I still think more missions. Maybe one person recruiting. Hopefully none of these people turn out to be faceless. Let me switch one of these squaddies over. We're going through squaddies pretty quick here. So, oops, wrong button. I always go to the wrong spot. squad management. So we sent a technical. He's already got promotions. We could pull him back, actually. We could switch him with someone else, but let's switch. And I like all these people. Let's switch Graham Rich out for now. Like I said, I'll be moving these people around. The Haven to get the new recruits. Haven advisors will be moved around in the future as we require them. But let's give them another one. Again, it's better to catch those spies earlier than later. And we got real lucky with Pandas. So Graham, you got to try to live up to Pandas' skills here. So I think we'll scan in West Asia for now. We can't afford to make more contacts. So there's not much. Oops. There's not much we can do on the campaign map right now other than choose where to scan. It just gives an intel bonus, so we've already got two missions here. Let's see if we can get one in West Asia that's reasonable. This is back to the original area. So this is one of these basically scam missions. You're never going to be able to do these, really. I could assign some soldiers, and theoretically we could try. But we'd get to like 20 or 30% infiltrated, and they'd be, instead of extremely light, extremely hard. And, you know, you'd just lose your team. So that's just bad luck, or not enough intel, or some combination of the two. I don't know the exact mechanic. But hopefully we can get a better mission. Okay, first room cleared. There's a ton of stuff I want to build, but I don't have the supplies for any of it. Actually, there's one thing we could do on the map. For now, we're just going to keep assigning engineers to clear out more and more of the base. After this is done, the engineer will have paid for himself, so I think clearly a good decision to start with him. I think we'll get enough to build our first facility as well. I really want to get these two buildings like ASAP, so our first free power, 6 power, we're going to be giving to these two, and after that we'll build a power relay and then whatever else we need to build. Resistance comms is great, but it's just we've got to get these two buildings up, you know, before then, basically, in my opinion. Okay, that's all we're doing here. I'm going to try, you know, we've done a couple missions. Theoretically, we could sell stuff at the black market. If I could get to 150 supplies, it might be worth selling, like, everything. I've got a fair number of trooper corpses. I don't need that many. I need a couple for alloys, but I don't think we can get to as high as what I need to build anything. Like, it's 150, right? So even if I sold, like, basically everything, we'd barely make it. Like, I almost never use these. I could definitely sell some of these guys. It's getting fairly close. We need the sectoid corpse to do an autopsy to get psionics, but we're not going to be able to build a psi lab for ages, so I guess we could sell him. Drone wrecks are actually really, really valuable to get your robotics going. Stocks are really good. Agility, I'm not a huge fan of as a PCS. You can't even equip these to your corporal anyway. Magazine size, pretty good. Laser sight, not that big of a deal. I mean, that's enough money. Alright, I think maybe I should have done that right after we got back from the mission. That would have saved us a little bit of time. Yeah, but, you know, like, the sooner we get these things built, the better, so. So I think, basically, Advanced War Center, Warfare Center gives you the ability to train extra perks onto people, which is awesome. And what else does it do? If you have a spare scientist, you can reduce wound timers, which is good. There's something else you can do there, too, I forget. Two slots for eight for maybe it's retraining? The Guerrilla Tactics School has training new rookies to be squaddies, training officers, and something else. And the Advanced Warfare Center has training extra perks onto people, wound recovery, and something else. But what do we really need? Do we want the officer or the extra perks first? Wound recovery is also pretty good to get. Like, if you start getting those 30, 40 day wound timers, that's pretty. I think we'll go with. I think I want to get an officer fairly quickly, so we'll go with that. Would it be worth putting the engineer over here? No. I'd rather we keep. Because if we don't have the engineer here, they can't clear debris, we won't get any supplies. Sure, we could put them here to save half the time, but we wouldn't get anything else. This will just build passively, whereas these require an engineer to actively dig them. Yeah, I think that's the way to do it. If I get another engineer, sure, but what's the chance of that happening? Scan in mode. Alright, we finished our research. Again, the volume... I'm sorry, I don't know why it's so loud for everybody. Maybe it's just loud for me. Maybe for you guys it's fine. I realize my headset might be turned up way louder than normal. My volume is not even working right now. Something's a little bit funky with the... just a sec. The Xcom 2... volume. Alright, well I turned it down to my headset, so maybe, like... Anyway, sorry, the cutscene that I accidentally skipped through because I thought it was super loud was all about the chip that they pulled out of your brain during the first mission that we didn't get to do because of Long War 2. And it's connected with... Well, it's some sort of brain chip that he's got some experience building. It's not that loud, maybe. Sorry. Playing with volume settings mid-recording. So AP rounds, not super important early on, but ignoring armor later on could be quite valuable. Now we can do more research options. I think I want to get hybrid materials next, and all I need for that is some alloys, which we can get from an Advent Trooper corpse. It might not be a horrible idea to go for like basic research either, because this will give us effectively plus one scientist as far as research times are concerned. You need more scientists also. It's either that or it just unlocks, like, if I finish basic research, maybe I could do a faceless autopsy, just because it would consider it as two. Anyway, I do think hybrid materials getting the guns going is a good idea.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander.
Alright.
I'll contact you when I have a full...
Tell you what. I'm going to turn the baseline volume up a little bit. I think it was just... it was all in my head was the problem. Wasn't... You guys are probably like, Blue, what are you talking about? It's not that loud. Alright, well, we're getting pretty close to our missions, so we'll have a couple missions. I was expecting more than two at once, so, I probably could have put more squaddies on them if I knew this was going to happen. But here we go. Alright, another nice long mission. Definitely want to do it. It's another... Well, it's a VIP rescue. So we've got like a jailbreak, a data hacking, and this is a VIP rescue. So this one gets us a new unit. A ranger with an intel package. So a new soldier. I feel like in 1.1 Long War 2, we're getting a lot more soldiers early on. I definitely don't remember getting this very often in 1.0 when I was first playing it. But anyway, we definitely want to do that mission. This one can be another new squad. And we'll deal with exactly who we send here in a second. So almost 8 days. Very light. So it's actually... I looked it up at one point, but I already forgot. But depending on the baseline activity, extremely light, I think, is 8 or 9 aliens or enemies. And then every step up from there adds a couple. So I think it goes extremely light, very light, light, or something like that anyway. And, you know, if it's 8 or 9 for extremely light, we're probably looking at 10 or 11 for very light, or, you know, ballparking, something like that. And then, of course, reinforcements, which can totally ruin your day, thanks to Long War. Oops. Fucking buttons all over the place. So, squad. Well, I guess we'll send the last two squaddies that haven't been on a mission. Or haven't been able to lead a mission. I do like sharpshooters, and grenadiers are pretty awesome for blowing up cover, eventually. And then we'll just fill them up with rookies as far as we can. I think we will be very near to the end of the named soldier roster after this. Basically, we've got enough for like three groups at once, barely. We'll probably fit one more on. Seven soldiers is better than six. All the way down to Pixel. Alright, yeah, that's pretty good. Probably bring a med kit, maybe put it on the sniper, less likely to be throwing grenades at people as a sniper. And an emergency bleed out med kit is probably a good idea. One thing with snipers, now that we've got the modular weapons, we definitely want to give the stock to the sniper. because it's more likely that they're not on Overwatch and that they're just preparing for a shot, so you can steady weapon for a plus 15 aim and then get a really good shot after that. Also, once we get there, can't even see it right now, but like their first ability is really, really good for combination with the stock. We'll talk about that after the mission. Other than that, you know, lots of grenades and armor. Not really going to change weapon around too much. Oh, I do have the mod kit, the expanded magazine. But I'd usually give that to like rangers or gunners who burn through their ammo super quick. Because they do double shots and high ammo cost moves. Assaults aren't bad either for expanded clip size. So anyway, the devils. Guess we're going to have to end the episode here. Well, I'll wait till the next mission is basically ready to start. I don't expect it'll take much longer.
Sky Ranger deploy.
Squad green to deploy.
And Scanny. Finished another research. We're just burning through this. So with these render type things, you can keep repeating them to get more. If you've got more corpses, you can keep rendering. But the whole point of getting those alloys was so that we could do hybrid materials. This will unlock all kinds of goodies. So yeah, this is good. The trooper autopsy is like plot based and leads to the officer autopsy. So like, this is important. Don't render the officer corpse if you've only got one. Even though it gives you more alloys than a trooper. But also, once you have the option to, I would recommend not rendering or destroying the drone wrecks, because you need the drone wrecks for a specific tech as well.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming
sure,
from this
thanks,
technology.
Tigan. He says that about basically everything.
As soon as the research is complete.
Everything's important to Tigan. Okay, we're at 100%. So even though theoretically we could wait 20 hours, we wouldn't really get any benefit to that. Like, we might get to 105 or 110%. I'd rather just get the mission out of the way, get the intel if we can, and basically get on with it. Now, sometimes if you go higher, you can get the enemy readiness down to vulnerable, and that might help out. Evac is kind of annoying because this is how long it takes once you call the Sky Ranger to pick you up for it to arrive. So that can suck. But yeah, we'll get this mission started next episode, Operation Dismal Hammer. I will be back. Well, I suppose I should put a save in for the end, but I'll be back with the beginning of that mission next episode. So thanks for watching, folks. Hope you guys have enjoyed. We had a quick little easy mission, so to say, today with the spy, and next one will be a little bit more serious, I think. So we'll see you guys there. Don't forget to leave some names if you'd like to join up. Unless this video has been out for a month or a year, in which case, hi guys. What you guys been doing all this time?
More resourceful than your average trooper.